इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 9 देर आर सिक्स चार्जेस केप्ट ऑन द कॉर्नर्स ऑफ ए रेगुलर हेक्सागन एंड द चार्जेस आर अल्टरनेटिवली पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव, प्लस क्यू माइनस क्यू प्लस क्यू माइनस क्यू प्लस क्यू एंड माइनस क्यू एंड फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द हेक्सागन इफ ए लाइन इज ड्रॉन परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ द हेक्सागन तो वी हैव टू फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट अ डिस्टेंस एक्स फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द हेक्सागन। ओके सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम वी हैव टू सॉल्व। वी हैव टू फाइंड द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड एट डिस्टेंस एक्स फ्रॉम द सेंटर ऑफ द हेक्सागन। देयर कुड बी टू वेज, बोथ आर बेस्ड ऑन सिमेट्री। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस फोकस ऑन एनी थ्री चार्जेस विच आर पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव। सो लेट अस से दीज थ्री चार्जेस आर ऑल पॉजिटिव एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दीज थ्री चार्जेस इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड विल बी वॉट बाय सिमेट्री द परपेंडिकुलर कंपोनेंट विल कैंसल, ओनली द कंपोनेंट अलॉन्ग दिस लाइन विल रिमेन, लेट अस से ई बिकॉज ऑफ दीज थ्री चार्जेस। नाउ बाय सिमेट्री इफ इन केस वी टेक दीज थ्री चार्जेस विच आर माइनस क्यू, दीज थ्री चार्जेस माइनस क्यू माइनस क्यू माइनस क्यू ऑल्सो लाई ऑन एन इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल एंड द सेंटर ऑफ द हेक्सागन इज ऑल्सो द सेंट्रॉइड ऑफ द इक्विलेटरल ट्राइंगल। If these three positive charges created an electric field E outside, these three negative charges must create an electric field E inside. So the net field at this particular point should be equal to zero. Okay. Alternatively, there was one more way to approach this problem. These are alternate positive and negative charges. We look at them as combination of different dipoles. Okay, and a dipole creates an electric field at equatorial point opposite to the dipole moment from negative to positive charge. The electric field it will create on the equatorial point will be opposite to the direction of negative to positive charge. The direction of negative to positive charge is called as dipole moment. So if we consider these two as dipoles, the dipole moment is in this direction, electric field due to them will be in this direction. If we consider these two as dipoles, the dipole moment will be in this direction. And again, if we create a plane parallel to that plane, in this condition, the electric field will be in this direction because of these two dipoles. And if we consider these two dipoles, minus q plus q, the dipole moment will be in this direction from negative charge to positive charge, and the electric field in this plane will be from positive to negative charge. Now these three vectors will form how much angle? 120 degree angle, and the resultant should be equal to zero. Okay, so question number 10 is there's a clock and on the clock charge negative charges are fixed. Here charge is minus q, here charges is minus 2q, here the charges is minus 3q, here it is minus 6q, minus 9q, minus 10q, minus 11q, and here it is minus 12q. Here the charge is 4q, here the charge is 5q, here the charge is 7q, here the charge is 8q. So we have to find the direction of the resultant electric field because of all these charges. So let us say, because of any charge Q, the electric field at the center is E, and that is equal to KQ divided by R square. This is the electric field created because of charge Q. So what will be the magnitude of electric field due to 2Q? It will be 2E. Due to 3Q, it will be 3E. Due to 4Q, it will be 4E, and so on. Now we can use the fact that if 12Q charge is there, opposite to it there is charge minus 6Q. If 12Q charge creates an electric field 12E upward, because it is negative, it will create the electric field towards the negative charge. 6E charge will create an electric field downward. So these two electric fields will be anti-parallel, and the resultant will be what? 6E towards minus 2Q charge. Similarly, if we compare minus 7Q and minus Q, minus 7Q will create an electric field 7E, and minus Q will create an electric field E. So resultant of this will be 6E towards minus 7Q. Similarly, 8N minus 2Q, minus 8E minus 2E, net will be 6E. 9 and 3, 6E. 10 and 4, 6E. 11 and 5, 6E. So we have included the contribution of all the charges now. Now we have to find the resultant of this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 vectors. And we have to only find the direction in which the resultant of this 6 vectors will point. The best way of doing this will be, let us add these two vectors first. Because the angle between them is 30 degree, and the resultant will pass from the center of these two, from the diagonal. Okay, so if now we eliminate these two vectors, the resultant will be in this direction between 9 and 10. Similarly, the resultant of the vector pointing towards 8 and vector pointing towards 11 will also be along the diagonal, the parallelogram law, whatever might be the vector, but it must be in between them. And finally, the vectors pointing towards 7Q and 12Q, the resultant will also be along the diagonal. Thus, the resultant of all these vectors will be between 9 and 10, and the answer should be therefore 9:30 p.m.